This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about the greatest integer function. So let's start out with the notation and the definition for this. The notation for greatest integer or greatest integer function is a pair of kind of double brackets, extra wide brackets, with either a variable or a number in between them. Now, sometimes what you'll see is just a pair of brackets like that. And sometimes the brackets may have the tops cut off, so it looks like an L and a backwards L. The definition for the greatest integer function goes something like this. The greatest integer value of x equals the greatest integer less than or equal to x. So let's try some numbers in here and see how this works. Let's say I've got the greatest integer value for 2.3. Now I'm going to explain this with a number line. So let's draw a number line. Here's 0, 1, 2, and 3. And 2.3 is going to be between the 2 and the 3. Let's call this 2.3. So I'm looking for a number which is less than or equal to 2.3. So I can draw an arrow on this number line from that 2.3 down to the left. And I want that number to be an integer. So an integer is a number that it's like a positive or a negative whole number. There's no decimals after it, there's no fractions after it. And I want the largest, the greatest integer I can find. So working down from 2.3 and going to the left, the first integer I get to is 2. So the greatest integer value of 2.3 is going to be 2. Now if I have a whole number, if I have an integer inside those brackets, let's say I have a 3 here, then it becomes very easy. So once again, I look at my number line. I start at 3, draw an arrow to the left. And since I'm looking for the greatest integer less than or equal to 3, I'll just use that 3 that I already have. Now, where this gets a little bit confusing is when we get to negative numbers. So let's do an example with a negative number. Let's say I've got greatest integer value of negative 1.6. So once again, to help me figure this out, I'll draw a number line. Here's 0, negative 1, and negative 2. So negative 1.6 will be between negative 1 and negative 2. And I'll draw an arrow to the left for all the numbers which are less than or equal to 1.6. The first integer I come to, moving to the left, is negative 2. Okay? So make sure that makes sense to you. My advice would be, if you have to find the greatest integer value for a negative number, unless you're absolutely sure, draw a number line for yourself to make sure that your answer is right. Okay, let's take a look at graphing these things. So let's say I've got f of x equals the greatest integer value of x, and I want to graph it. I'm going to make a table of values for my x and my y values, and let's just start with x equaling 0. So when x is 0, then the greatest integer value of 0 is going to be 0, so my y will also be 0. That means I'm going to have a dot here at the origin. Let's jump up to the next integer. Let's go to where x equals 1. Well, when x equals 1, since that is an integer, y will also equal 1. Okay? So I'm going to have another dot here at 1, 1. And the same thing would happen if I jump down to 2. The greatest integer value of 2 is also 2. So I'll have a dot here at 2, 2. Now, let's fill in some numbers in between the 0 and the 1. if I have 0.1 and I want the greatest integer value of 0.1, well, I'm going to have to go down from 0.1 to an integer, and that's going to be 0. Same thing would happen for 0.2. That's going to be 0. And that's going to happen all the way up to, but not quite including, 1. So in other words, 0.999 would give me a greatest integer value of 0. So on the graph, that means I'm going to draw a line right here along the x-axis. And I'm going to stop just before I get to the 1. So I'll draw a round and open circle to show that I'm stopping. Then when I go up beyond 1, if I've got 1.1, the greatest integer value for 1.1 is just 1. Same thing happens for 1.2. Same thing would happen for 1.999. The greatest integer value for that is also just 1. So that means I'm going to have another horizontal line from 1 over 2, but not including the 2. After I get to the 2, I'm going to continue this pattern. I'll draw a horizontal line up to, but not quite including the 3. From 3, 3, I'll go over to where x equals 4. If I want to do the negative numbers, once I've got a pattern like this, rather than calculate what the negative greatest integer values would be, I'm just going to move my way down with that same pattern. So I'm going to go to negative 1, negative 1, move horizontally to the right, and then draw an open circle when I get to y equals 0, move down to negative 2, negative 2, go over to the right, draw another open circle, and so on. Okay, so that's it for the graph of the basic greatest integer function. I don't want to make this video too long, so what I'm going to do is I'll do another video with some graphs of some more complicated versions of this function. Okay, but that's going to be it for this one. So stick around. I'll see you soon.